what you can expect when you're a fragrance shill for Michael Malone. What it's like to be in a Navitus meeting.
Another one. Another one. Another one. Another one. Another one. And another one. And another one.
When Joey Cannoli and Dan, Mr. AKA Mr. Smelly, meet on the stream. On everybody, it is your boy. Welcome in to Fat Boy Fragrance Reviews, and I'm Mr. Fat Boy, of course. I'm so glad to have you here. The straight hardest working man in this fragrance game, the straight freestyle king of this fragrance game. No edits, no do-overs, one take and we get it right. Welcome in. Today we are reviewing a brand new one from Mont Blanc. Been a lot of hype on this one. It's time for your boy to give his full feelings on it. My genuine feelings on it. Can't wait to share with you. Now, if you are new to this channel and you just first time checking me out, boy, I'm so glad to have you here. Come on in, baby. Pull up a seat. Get you some popcorn and enjoy the show. Because I promise you a place of positivity, of energy. And I promise you, baby, I bring it 100 every time. All right. If you want to sample Mont Blanc Legend Red, you can at fatboyfragrance.com. It's up for available for sampling. Well worth you checking out. So if you want to check it out, it's there waiting on you. And I appreciate it so much for all the support you've been showing the store. By supporting fatboyfragrance.com, you're supporting me to allow me to continue to buy, to give you reviews, to make sure you get the correct fragrances you need in your collection. All right, baby, let's get all up in it. And you know how we do it, baby. No edits, no do-overs. Just one take and one take and we get it right. Fat Boy Fragrance Review starts now. Boy, I was feeling the music. I was feeling it, baby. Music break off the jump. Welcome in. We back, baby. A little bit of UB40 to get this drive started, to get this thing started, to get it all going in the right direction. I told you I won't be going long. All right. Today, we're reviewing one from the house of Mont Blanc. Here she is. Here he is. Mont Blanc Legend Red. Now, before I get started, I have three Mont Blancs, the original old school legend. This thing is about 8 or 9 years old. Golly. Still smells amazing. I'm gonna put it up here on my arm so we can kind of have it smelling there as we'll compare it. God, that thing smells, still smells amazing. Then I have Mont Blanc Legend Spirit. Great fragrance, more on the lines of say Invictus Aqua, put it over here. Another banger, I mean straight banger. These two are bangers. And the newest one that came out a couple years ago, Mont Blanc Eau de Parfum EDP. This one's more than a nighttime banger. I got a video on this one, you can check it out. We're gonna put that one right here on this wrist right here. Check out the watch, check out the color coordination, baby. Wow. All right, feeling the music today, feeling it. All right, so here's the brand new one, Mont Blanc Legend Red. There's the box, standard legend box that come in. Let's check out the bottle, give it a good clean real quick. All right, here we go. Birds, God, finger prick manic. Sorry about that, guys. There's the bottle. Standard Mont Blanc Legend bottle. Love these bottles because they're easy to hold, easy to spray. Boy, love this song. Love this song. So, Mont Blanc Legend Red is the newest flank. Is my only concern when I go in the flankers is this. Is it too much like the original? Is it way too different and not on the same, not showing respect and love to the original? That's what we got to kind of take our hands on this one, see what we got here. So let's find out. There's been some good reviews about it, a lot of positivity about this one, and I can't wait to share you my full opinions on it. I paid for it. Like I said, you can sample this at fatboyfragrance.com. Fatboyfragrance.com, where the customer is always right. Check out the color coordination, baby. Bam! All right. Let's pull up the notes, and then we'll get down to business. I've been a big fan of Legend. Like I said, Mont Blanc, for most part, has made great fragrances that I've enjoyed a lot. All right, so on the notes of this bad boy, this is considered a kind of a citrus aromatic woody fragrance. Fresh, spicy, warm, sweet. So far on Fragnatica, people are liking it. All right, so the top notes are blood orange, grapefruit, cardamom. Love that top notes combination there. You got me. I'm in. Cedar in the middle, juniper berries, clary sage, mahogany wood in the bottom, tonka bean, and Atlas cedar. So, not a lot in there, but take heed right away to the blood orange and to the grapefruit and the cardamom. They are stars in this fragrance. Off the jump. All right, so let's go ahead and put it on the skin. That's the only way to know. We'll check out the atomizer, see how it feels, see how it looks. Here we go. Oh, missed it. There we go. Put it in the air. Right away, this is different than all three of them. Whereas the original gives you that old classic kind of fresh vibe, you know, kind of reminds me a little bit of Calvin Klein, Attorney for Men. Or it just has that nice citrus, fresh, zesty vibe to it that's easy to wear on any date, any time of the day. Great, but leans more to the warmer months. This one is just straight up Invictus Aqua, and it's really great, and it does the job, and it does it really well. And then Parfum was kind of the ones we could wear in the winter that you can just get in the winter and wear, and it was just a little heavier, but fantastic too. One of the most underrated fragrances that even came out that year. But this one, my man. Wow. You got the DNA. Let me break it down like this. Let's get my pet peeves out of the way first. Does it smell too much like the original? No. Is it way too far of a departure from the original? No. Oh, man. What you know about that Bob Marley, baby? So, it's not a big departure from the original. That's a big plus. I love that. All right. Those two things check out. We're off to a good start with the flanker. This one will run you about $100 on Bloomingdale's, a place like that. You give it about five or six months, you'll find it on discount sites for about $60-$70. All right. Let's find out if it's worth your time now. You might need to wait, or you might just need to sample it. Huh. Doesn't smell like the other ones. It's its own great fragrance. They could not call this Mont Blanc Legend, but it does have the DNA. It's there. My wife noticed it right away. She loves Legend. Most women do. Man, this thing is banging. All right, how I can point out this fragrance, it's like taking a powdery version of Bleu de Chanel Eau de Parfum and mixing it with Legend. It's kind of the vibe I get out of this. The blood orange is beautiful. The grapefruit, oh, I love the note of grapefruit. One of my favorite notes. Oh, Lord have mercy. Man, I am not playing hard to get with this one. So you get a beautiful citrusy cardamom sweet vibe up front. The sweetness is what's popular right now, and that's fine. Does it go too far? No, it stays right in its lane. It's great. As this fragrance starts to dry down, the top is still the star. The cardamom is still the star. The citrus notes are still the star. But you do get a sense of a really nice woody dry down. It's just enough to increase, to amp up the masculinity and to amp up the performance. So phenomenal job here on this one. Now, let's find out if Mont Blanc's Legend Red gets my full Fat Boy seal approval. All right, performance. Man, probably the best performing Mont Blanc Legend out there. And that is saying a lot. Not a lot, because they don't really perform that good. I think Spirit was the best performing one of the bunch, because it had that DNA of Invictus Aqua, and Aqua was a pretty beastly mold fragrance. But this one beats them all. I forgot to bring my decant with me, so I only sprayed it once, and I could smell it on my clothes when I got home. My scent bubble was solid. Scent trail was solid for 3 hours at least. People could still smell me from a little distance. That surprised the heck out of me for a designer fragrance. Great. I don't understand why so many people jumped to Dior Sauvage and Bleu de Chanel EDP and call these one the best out there. I know this is a flanker, but it's probably going to win some Yeah Awards. It's probably going to win Best Flanker, and it's probably going to get nominated for Best Fragrance of the Year, without a doubt. Huh. So take that right now. It's early in the Yeah Awards, but this one's putting up a great fight. All right. Performance, check the box. Does the wifey like it? Is it compliment getter? Check the box. People will notice you wearing this one easily. No reason to go into it. It's amazing. People are going to love the way you smell. All right. And the third box. Do I like it? How much? Do I like it? Do I love it? I love this one, man. This one is amazing. My favorite Legend, I think, right now is this one. Great job, Mont Blanc. Great job for giving us something that's a little unique, but not too far away to show respect to the OG. That's all the time I got, baby, though. Full Fat Boy seal approval on Mont Blanc Legend Red. What did I do with my phone? It's in my pocket. No edits, baby. No edits. So, we're going to go out with some more UB40. Before we do that, a little bit of a music break at the end. So, if you like the review, and you can go ahead and leave now, because now we're doing a music break. I hope y'all enjoyed the video. I hope you enjoyed the music. Y'all stay safe. Y'all stay well, baby. And if you smell good and you feel good, then baby, it's gonna be all good. Fat Boy Fragrance Reviews is out.